we are back. We're back here. We're still at range day. Still at the Umarex booth because it's the only air guns to shoot out here. And so we're going to be here all day long. I'm going to move you out of the sun. Look at this.
Okay. Thing.
And I'm going to keep you out of the sun because it's going to be a better shot. Right?
Well, I got fair skin.
Well, right. And the makeup lady didn't come today.
It's weird.
So.
Yeah.
Doing this on a whim. All right. So we got to shoot the Primal 20. Awesome gun. Now we're moving over here. This is the AirSaber Elite X2, correct?
That's right. The X2 being times two.
Listen.
We're trying to go over the longest name we can make.
Yeah. Well, this is a big bore aero gun. Because I don't know if you guys know this, that it's 2022. It's the year of the Airgun Hunter.
It is?
Yeah, it's the year of it.
That's right. It is.
Umarex is
It's the year of the Airgun Hunter.
Hashtag.
There it is.
So just put that.
It's going to be right there.
So I don't want anyone to forget it. This is a hunting gun. This is a big bore. There's not any big game. You're not hunting with this gun, correct?
You can hunt everything with this gun.
Yeah.
North America, hunt it.
Give me a rundown of it. Take me through it. Give me some numbers.
Okay, so if the first thing you'll feel when you pick this thing up and you put it in your hands,
yep,
is the AirSaber, when you first shot that gun, has, yep, that sleek feel, fits right up against you, snug.
Yep.
It just really tucks in there. You can't even feel the weight difference in it.
Wow.
You cannot even detect the weight difference between the double barrel or whether it's not a double barrel.
Agreed.
And the fit and feel is the same. So it comes with a scope.
Yeah.
So you got this thing piled in with a scope. You're like $499. You got a 4,000 PSI tank that's on the front of this thing.
4,000?
4,000 PSI tank.
Okay.
So you're getting like 25 shots out of this thing. So if I don't even know if you could buy that many arrows. So if you bring that many arrows, 25 shots, it'd be like,
shots?
Oh my gosh, like you'd have to have like a backpack with a quiver. Just there could be a bunch like that big.
Okay.
So you have that from here. What tells you which side you're shooting off of, and that's the question I get a lot, is, well, how do you know which barrel you're shooting out of? If this is poking out, and you can see right here, there's a little red O-ring on there.
Yeah.
This is the barrel that it's going to be shooting out of.
Okay.
And you can push it over to this side. So you have this one here.
Yeah.
We're firing out of this barrel first. When you get ready to shoot again, you push this over, you cock the gun, and you fire, and that thing's ready to shoot out of the next barrel. You can get two shots off in 2 seconds. I want to see if you can do it, because I know I can do it. I've been practicing with it, so.
Two shots off in 2 seconds?
Two shots off in 2 seconds, and have it on target. I think you can do it. We'll just do two shots and let you shoot that first, and then we'll see if you can get two shots in 2 seconds.
Wow. Okay.
So pretty much you take it from here, you go fire, boom, back to here, cock, back down here, and then back on target and fire, and you're two shots in 2 seconds. I mean, it's truly like if you're gonna be hunting.
Yeah.
I mean, that's better than anything.
Tell me
in
this:
archery.
If you lined up, you had this thing steady, you lined up and you shot around the target. Are they gonna land next to each other, or are they designed to shoot into the?
So that's a great question. So the converging barrels is what everybody asks, because these barrels converging kind of like a shotgun's like that. Eventually, there's a point where it kind of crosses.
Yeah.
It does not. They run parallel the whole time.
Okay.
So you shoot it at 25 yards. They will be the distance it's up here, which is about the width of my finger from here between the two.
Okay.
So that's what'll hit. Those two there, you shoot it at 100 yards, it'll shoot those same distances as long as you put them in the same spot and in the same hole.
Okay, so something to be a little bit aware of, right, when you're shooting. If you're looking at your scope, you know it's gonna just be a little bit left and a little bit right of your crosshair, right? Because they're,
correct.
This is split in the middle.
Right.
Okay. And so, but I mean, we're talking.
Yeah, you're talking that much.
Like nanometers.
Half, yeah, half inch.
I don't even know, or a half inch.
Yeah, the width of a pellet, a 30 caliber pellet.
I like nanometers.
Well, that's because nano is like a cool word. That's what everybody's using. It's like modern.
Especially this year. The year of the Airgun Hunter.
The year of the Airgun Hunter.
All right.
Okay.
Here we go.
So you're standing.
Is standing the best way to do it?
You can do it standing or sitting down, whatever you want.
How many
to.
25 shots. Let me shoot two of them first, and then let me try the. Let me just get the feel of it first.
Yeah, and I think you'll get it because I think it'll be the flow.
All right.
So what I do is I take from here. So I put the white towards the outside.
I want to see this
in the barrel here.
Yeah.
So that the fletching, and I'll show you here as we put it in.
Yeah.
So we set this right here on the outside.
Okay.
So the fletching isn't really touching if the white's to the outside. So everything's kind of separated.
Ah.
And not that I really think it matters if it's coming off the rails anyways.
Yeah.
It's just gonna be slinging down range at 450 feet per second. Same saber speeds. Okay, so now we got
450 feet per second. Oh,
yes.
Look how cool that looks.
Is that cool or what? Can you imagine that with broadheads?
I mean, right?
Put some like thorns on there.
Yeah.
Put those.
But they gotta be something probably mechanical, right? So they don't.
Or you just go with the thorns. The thorns, you know, they're tight enough in there, but I mean,
okay,
yeah, that's a bad mamma jamma.
Killer.
If you're gonna buy a motor scooter, this is the baddest motor scooter out there. So,
oh my gosh, that is easy.
Yep. So we're gonna push this over here. Start you on the left barrel.
Why start on the left? Does it matter?
Because when you get ready to fire, all you have to do is take your thumb.
Oh, then just
as soon as you fire, click it over, cock it, and then you can shoot again. We'll just shoot two rounds and go for it. So we'll just send it down range.
All right, so what's the challenge here? The challenge is to see if I can do this in 2 seconds?
Well, you could do it in 2 seconds, but you haven't even shot this gun like this before. Or you just want to try it right off the
Let's
bat?
Let's try it right off the bat.
You just want to do it right off the
Let's
bat?
Just right off the bat.
Okay, so you're going to fire, push over, cock, fire again. Nice. And just put it right on the center of the target. So whenever you're ready and your safety is off, so you're good to go.
Will the safety kick back on when
it
I cock?
It will not automatically kick back on. Nope.
Okay, here we go. Who's counting? You're counting. Ready, go.
1,001, 1,000.
Hey, John, you want here?
Here's the best part. Let's bring it back to us. We got Nat Warfare's cool little gadget over here. Mobile target.
Bring it up, offhand, two shots, less than 2 seconds.
Right to the camera. Look at that.
So
that's the first time you shot it, and you did
that's
it in 2 seconds.
That's the first time I've shot it.
So that's really good.
That
if you practice, you'll stack it right next to each other. I'm telling you, dude, this thing is like.
All right, let me get two more. I just want to take it. I want to dial in. I want to see what kind of.
You want to do some accuracy, like.
Yeah.
Okay, let me pull the arrows out.
I mean, this is.
We bring the target to us here.
Yeah, we're
lazy, not doing. We got
lazy right
we
now.
Got all of Nat Warfare's cool stuff. So let me send it back out.
All right, while you're doing that, I want to load this sucker up.
I want to experience it. So white tips out. A white tip sound.
Yep, put the white tips out on the outside there. I'm going to go park our target down here. And it won't fall out of a tree stand. So that's a lot of things. A lot of people are like, well, this thing fall out of the tree stand. There's no like definitive knock like you have like on the javelin. Nope. You just slide it down. It's a little bit lubed up on there. You can tilt that gun upside down and hold it there for a month and it wouldn't come out of there. Not coming out of there. This is not coming out.
Wow.
All right. So now you can sit down if you want to. You can swing the chair around.
Yeah.
Oh, you just gonna do it that way?
The old squatty McSquat.
Oh yeah, I like that. It's where stability is the best.
It's my favorite. I'm off kilter here. I'm leaning to the left. That's all right. What distance? Which crosshair? There's four of them in there. Which one am I looking at?
You're looking at the center crosshair at the top.
Center crosshair at the top. Okay.
Center crosshair at the top.
I pulled that one. Oh man, that is sick, dude.
It's sick, I'm telling
you. Sick. You know what this should be? You're the Airgun Hunter.
This year. 2022.
There was a lot of fun stuff here from Umarex.
Last year was close, but it couldn't be.
No, it's just
It has
true.
To be this year.
Listen, we already kicked off 2022 with an elk hunt. First bull elk down with an air gun, the Umarex 50 cal. Now we've got that much more exciting stuff to go out and hunt with. It's going to be
awesome. And on top of that, we got 30 cal gauntlets. You know what? That's nothing but an iguana smasher, too.
That's true.
Just going out and getting iguanas.
And then we didn't even really get to it, but there's also the AirSaber Pro, which is, you know, the AirSaber, but not CO2. It's the PCP version.
And it's faster.
So we, whoa!
It's even faster.
I hit the button. All right, hey, I got to know better. Forgot about the,
That's right.
The back adjustable stock. All right, that's a lot. That's a lot here. We've just gotten started. It's day one of SHOT Show. It's range day. Had to come here by Umarex. I heard about all this cool stuff coming, and now I've seen it. So, I mean, basically, just right now, what we're seeing right here, and we're seeing more at the booth.
Oh, we've the booth's got tons.
We got the AirSaber Pro. We've got the, we got the Air Javelin Pro.
Air Javelin
Pro.
We
got the Umarex AirSaber Elite X2.
Correct.
We got the Primal 20.
Primal 20.
The 20 gauge. We've got the Gauntlet 30 cal.
Gauntlet 30 cal. Classic gauntlet that everybody's been working with.
Yeah.
It's slinging a 30 caliber, and it's smoking.
Everything, and then the 25 caliber version of
the Origin. That's when you haven't shot. And the Origin is like my probably
that's entry level.
It's entry level, but this one's not entry level. Like I could stack it in a small pellet tin can at 100 yards with that thing unregulated. That thing is the craziest thing in the world. I'm telling you, it's probably one of my favorite guns. The Origin is. It's entry level, but it's side cocking lever. It's fast. It just shoots like nice groups. I did a nice like thing on YouTube for it.
Yeah.
But the 25, impressed even more.
I can see why Umarex is doing the year of the Airgun Hunter, because there's a lot of cool stuff to hunt with.
I didn't even take that thing like iguana hunt. It's fast. It's awesome.
Speaking of, my man's got an iguana hunt coming out on American Airgunner this season in about 6 weeks. So make sure you guys are watching the show, Sportsman Channel, every Thursday night at 9:30. You're going to see Aiden. You're going to see us. We're doing a lot of hunting. But this year it's going to get even better, because this is the year
of the Airgun Hunter.